Well, I was born in Newcastle in New South Wales, because my parents, my mum and dad, were the Salvation Army officers. We had a very exciting, happy family because I was number 8 in the family. And funnily enough, I was born on Sunday morning. And I was born at home because in those days there were often midwives who came to the home. And the midwife was quite excited and wanted to tell the father that the baby had come. And my father was in the Salvation Army church next door. And she went in, she opened the door and said, "The baby's come." And my father said, "Shh, go away, I'll come later." And when my father came to see me, he lifted me up and he made a prayer over my life. When I was only just an hour or so old. And it was a beautiful prayer, praying that I would be a person of value in the world. And he said something like, "We pray that you will bless her and make her a value to the whole world," which was a pretty tall order for a little baby. But, you know, in an amazing way, my father's prayer was answered. I was then posted to Africa in what was then called Rhodesia, but is now called Zimbabwe. And as a missionary teacher, living with the African people, again, I loved it, identifying with the African people, learning another language, learning to see another culture. And so it was a thrilling time, and I thought I was going to be there all my life. As I traveled the world as a gentleman, I met diverse leaders, as diverse really as, for example, Margaret Thatcher. And then I met Castro, who was the last communist leader of the world, who's still alive. And I met him also. I was able to meet presidents in America, in the Oval Office. I've got a few pins that I can wear that says, "You have been in the Oval Office." So I met President Reagan and President Bush. But then, you know, I've been retired quite a long time. These are a bit older names. I met many kings and queens. There are not many in the world, you know, but I seem to have met them all. My times meeting the Queen of England, the Queen of the Commonwealth of Nations, they were very interesting because I was invited to Buckingham Palace for lunch. And the Queen has about every 3 months, she has luncheon with, say, 10 people, and she chooses from all the different walks of life. So there was a famous pianist there, there was the famous admiral of the British fleet, there was a famous dress designer, and so we sit around the table together and chat with the Queen, our Lord Wallace, who kept up the conversation. I think that they put him there so that we wouldn't all be a bit too nervous. We're sitting quite near the Queen. Anyway, he began to talk about the Salvation Army. And he said, "I admire them very much, Your Majesty." He said, "But I myself am an atheist." So everybody kind of smiled a little bit. But then later, when the High Commissioner gave the toast to the Queen and we all stood up, we held our glasses and we said, "The Queen." This Lord Willis said, "God bless you, Ma." And I said to him, "I thought you were an atheist." And the Queen laughed so much, she clapped her hands and she said, "General Burrows, that's a marvellous joke." So when they say the Queen was not amused, I can say I once did amuse her. Because I am an ordained minister and a preacher of the gospel, I would say, "Mr. President, would you allow me to pray for your country and for your leadership?" And I never had one say no. Even Castro. I can always remember Monsieur Mitterrand in France. He said to me, "I'm always interested to help the Salvation Army because you care for the people that other people don't want to know." Power's the big thing. Yeah, I might have had difficulty with that if I'd been a politician, where you are really seeking power. I would like to use power to the advantage of everyone, not for myself. I think I think I would not be concerned for myself, but seeing if I could use my life for other people. When, for example, I came to Australia as the leader, I was the first woman to ever do that. So I knew some of the men thought, now this young whippersnapper is a bit too young. And they were waiting to see me come a flop. I think, particularly for young people, is to set your priorities, I think. And have an idea what your goals are. So you have your goals and you have your values. And you may not even be a regular churchgoer or attender like I would see our people in the Salvation Army, but you still have values that guide your decision making. And I think that that's important. Set your goal, set your priorities, have your values, make them work together, and be as unselfish as possible.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to present to you the general elect of the Salvation Army, Commissioner Eva Burrows.
Would you like a Coca-Cola before you go?